Everybody in the women's cell had their shoes on, except me. And I kept saying, I don't have my back covered. Someone brought a t-shirt, they threw it away. Could you please then let me at least wear my shoes? They cheated us, we are going to an office, they whisked us out through the basement, and that's when they drove us there. But I want to say, I don't take lightly. Even the policeman who was telling me, ati hakuna haja ya kupiga mama, sijui nini, sisi tunawapromote tu, wakati yule mwingine anafanya. That is sexual harassment, even without touching me. It is such, it upset me so much, I began singing to Mary, the mother of God in Latin. So I ask the churches, I say to the churches, take the country back, exorcise these people out of our nation. But don't just do it by praying. Let people know that it is hurting. It is very painful to be abused like that. And someone thinks actually is facing you with a lot of strength, bouncing up and down, telling you they are doing it on behalf of the executive. What have we taken from the executive? They are the ones who have taken from us. And all we were saying is that I had 2 packets of unga. And of course, it's difficult to buy unga today. All I was saying outside parliament, it wasn't even an assembly. Since when did you have an assembly of 2 people? It wasn't an assembly. We were just saying, unga itayamushwa na mwizi, ni mwizi. Hatujui PNU, hatujui ODM, tunataka mahindi yetu. Wamama wanakufa, watoto wanakufa. And we all have a right. Besides, they protected the women from Ruto's constituency. About 60 of them who were actually on the side of parliament. We were not even on the side of parliament. Those women taunted me to the end, and towards the end when I was being arrested, one of them was still saying, "Mchukue huyu." So I was asking them, why are you arresting us but not them? There is total hatred and looking down upon civil activists' rights, but we are used to that. We don't care for honors. Today, I've walked bare feet from my house to look for my shoe in Central. They abused me about the shoe. They said we cannot record the statement against Mugwai, we can go to Ali. But I'm asking, must I go to Vigilance House for policemen to learn how to act? There must be something wrong in Vigilance House. The Waki report has very, very serious statements on police. Women were saying we ran to those whom we thought would protect us. They did not. That bit that Fwamba talked about a dark cell, please tonight, if anybody in the police is hearing me, women have a right to have light in their cells after they have been arrested. They also have a right to a toilet which they can access without going through the male section, because they are harassed by those same men who are in. And I want to repeat that with a lot of force. When I was first arrested at Mutaiga, there was a baby and a mother in a dark cell. I refused to enter that cell. The same thing, in Kigiri, they wanted me to go into a dark cell. After that, it's terror, because I remember that the first night after being let out, I could not sleep with the light off. I just said, no. Suddenly I realized light, they had done something to me with darkness, because why should I be guarded by 2 men? And are there no police women officers in this country? 2 men taking me to a dark cell in the night, and there's nobody else in the station who is being held except one by whom they have hidden somewhere else there. For how do I know what are their intentions? And they are people who have already been saying, we don't fight women, we promote them. This word promote was a dirty word. They were using it to say other things, and that's why I started singing a religious song. I care for this nation. I pray for this nation. I don't pray for a seat in Bunge. I pray for my voice to be heard. And that's why I'm a writer, and that is why I shall not stop.